Dear students, welcome to the problem solving session on Stokes Theorem. In this session, we are going to verify Stokes Theorem for a given problem over a cube. Verify Stokes Theorem for a given f vector, where s is the surface of the cube bounded by the lines x equal to 0 to 2, y equal to 0 to 2 and z equal to 0 to 2. And it is very important, Stokes Theorem can be verified only for the open surface. The surface should not be closed. That's why it is clearly given in the question, above the xy plane. So that means one surface is left out. Let us go into the problem. As usual, let us take the given f vector as step 1. Now, before going to step 2, let us visualize the cube. So let us take x, y and z axis and then draw a cube whose size is 2. Therefore, my origin is going to be at this point 0, 0, 0. Now, the length here is 2, 0, 0 at x. Similarly, at y, we have 0, 2, 0 and z, we have 0, 0, 2. Here, it is clearly mentioned in the question, above xy plane. That means, this is my x and this is my y. So, in this cube, they have just left the bottom surface. We know it has 6 surfaces, front, back, right, left, top, bottom. So, above xy plane means they are just neglecting the bottom. So, the figure looks like this. So, now we are going to evaluate only for 5 surfaces, front, back, right, left and top, since the bottom is neglected. Now, let us go into the step 2. We are going to write the limits. It is very easy. All my lower limits for x, y, z are 0 from the given question. X equal to 0, y equal to 0 and z equal to 0. And my upper limits are going to be x equal to 2, y equal to 2 and z equal to 2 students. Done. Step 3, we have to write the Stokes Theorem. Integral over C for a closed line integral f vector dot dr vector is equal to double integral over S. People say it as curl f vector dot n cap ds, or you can write it as del cross f vector dot n cap ds. Both are correct. Very important, S should be a open surface and C should be a closed line integral. So now first we will deal with RHS, then we will go for LHS. To find RHS, we need del cross F vector. Let us find this and then we will go for the table to find all the 5 surfaces. This is my F vector. I want to find del cross F vector. We know our del F for the given F vector. It is easy for us to write the del cross F. It is going to be a determinant. First row we have I, J, K, and in the second row for del, the corresponding value dou by dou X, dou by dou Y and dou by dou Z. For the third row, we have to write the coefficients of I, J and K, and we have to expand the determinant. So let us find the expansion. So we have I vector dou by dou y of minus xz minus dou by dou z of yz plus 4 minus j vector dou by dou y of y minus z plus 2 minus dou by dou x of yz plus 4. Similarly, for k we can write dou by dou x of yz plus 4 minus dou by dou y of y minus z plus 2. You can see in the screen. Now, we have to differentiate partially each term. For this term, we'll be having I vector. So, there is no y. It will become 0. Here we have z. So, yz differentiation with respect to z is minus y. For this term, x is there. So, minus j vector. When I differentiate with respect to x, we'll be having minus z. And here, first term, no z, it is 0. This is also 0. So, we'll be getting minus 1, but there is one minus outside. So, minus into minus, plus. And for the third term, there is no x value. It is going to be 0. But here we have y. So, differentiation of y partially with respect to y is 1. We'll be having minus 1. So, we can write finally del cross f vector is minus yi vector minus j minus z plus 1 minus k vector. Further, we can simplify this and we can write as minus yi vector. Taking the minus outside, it will become z minus 1 into j vector minus k vector. So, del cross f vector is done, students. Now, this part is done. Next, we have to find n cap and ds, we have to do this as usual using the table. So now to calculate RHS, we need 5 surfaces, students. Since the bottom surface is removed from the figure, we have only 5 surfaces, that is S1, S2. We know very well from Gauss divergence theorem, we are very strong in it. S1 and S2 are front and back surfaces. Then S3 and S4 are going to be my right and left surface. And finally, S5 is going to be my top, since the bottom surface is neglected. Now let us go to the table and fill the contents. So in Gauss divergence theorem, we write F vector. Here we have to write del cross F vector, because according to Stokes formula, we need to find del cross F vector dot n cap. So let us fill surface space equation n cap values ds. It is well known to you. Now instead of 7 rows, we are going to take 6 rows, because we neglect the bottom of the given cube. As usual, fill the surfaces S1 to S5. The faces are going to be front back, right left and top alone. And equation is very easy. For front back, it is going to be x. For right left, it is going to be y. And top, it is going to be z. So front, right and top, we are going to give the maximum value. That is my upper limit. Back, left, we are going to give the least value. That is my lower limit. So it is very easy. Done. And n cap also I said ii, jj, k. So for front, we are going to give I vector. For back, it is going to be minus I vector, because unit outward normal, it travels in the opposite direction at the back. Similarly, j minus j and k vector. You can see the typed version. So now del cross F vector is immediately available. I'm going to take dot product with n cap. Minus y plus y, z minus 1, minus of z minus 1 and minus 1. Done. Here values, we have to substitute if something is here. X equal to 2, there is no x term. Similarly, there is no y term in right left. There is no z term in the top. No problem. If something is there, we have to substitute. If nothing is there, just write as it is. Values are done. Now, for the front and back surfaces, we have exhausted x. So, it will have dy, dz or dz, dy. According to your need, you can rearrange it. Similarly, for right and left, y is exhausted. We can use dx, dz. For top, we have dx, dy. So next, as I said, don't integrate everything individually. Since you see here, dy, dz is going to be common for these two surfaces, front and back. So I am going to club this front and back together and I can solve. What is the benefit here? See, here we have minus y and plus y. When I add together, minus y plus y get cancelled. The answer is immediate. You don't want to integrate. It is going to be 0. See here, double integral S1 plus double integral S2 del cross F vector dot n cap ds is going to be minus y plus y. Immediately we'll get 0. Similarly, we have to take S3 and S4. Here we can see S3 as z minus 1 and S4 as minus of z minus 1. I can club this 2 also. Then we will get the answer very easily. Z minus 1 and z minus 1 get cancelled. My answer is going to be 0. So 4 surfaces, we have get the answer in a very quick way. Now finally, double integral over S5 is left out. Let us have a look on the table. For S5, the value is minus 1 and the limits are going to be x and y, because we have dx, dy. It is very, very easy to integrate, students. You can easily say now, since the limits are 0 to 2, 0 to 2, my answer is going to be minus 4. Done. But we have to write in a proper way. So double integral over S5 is going to be integral 0 to 2, 0 to 2, del cross F vector dot n cap is minus 1, dx, dy. Either you can take dx, dy or you take dy, dx. It's going to be the same. The reason is all my limits are constant. Now integrating this, we'll be getting x. Substituting the upper and lower limit, we'll be getting minus 2 integral 0 to 2 dy. Again, integrating this, we'll be getting minus 2 into y in limit 0 to 2. So we get the answer minus 4. That's it, students. Therefore, my RHS is going to be minus 4. Next, our job is to prove the LHS is also minus 4. Done. Now, in Stokes theorem, what would be the LHS? It is closed integral or closed line integral over f vector dot dr vector. What is this? How to find this? So before going into the visualization, let us find the content which is needed for our problem solving purpose. For this, f vector is given in the question and we have to write dr vector and we have to take the dot product. Let us do this first and then we can go for the pictorial representation. This is my f vector. At the beginning of the unit, I said we have to take r vector as xi vector, yj vector and zk vector. From this, it is easy to get dr vector. It is obvious, dxi vector plus dyj vector plus dzk vector. Now we have to do dot product. F vector dot dr vector is going to be y minus z plus 2 dx plus yz plus 4 dy minus xz dz. Done, students. Now f vector dot dr vector is ready. But it consists of all the x, y, z terms and its derivatives. But our concern is a closed line integral. So it is going to be single integral. Now recall from the question, it is very clear, line integral over the simple closed curve at z equal to 0. Why? Because we have neglected the bottom surface. Equation of the bottom surface is z equal to 0. Therefore, I am going to take z equal to 0 and its derivative dz equal to 0. So, I am going to convert this into simply x and y because the bottom surface is neglected in the question. Now, substituting dz 0, this term will become 0 and this is 0 and this is 0. Therefore, my f vector dot dr vector will become simply y plus 2 dx plus 4 dy. So, in Stokes theorem, it is very important, student, which surface is neglected, write the corresponding equation. Suppose, if it is z equal to 0 or z equal to a, doesn't matter. When you took the derivative, dz is going to be 0. And we have to substitute this in f vector dot dr vector. It will give only the result in terms of two variables. Here, x and y. Done. See the figure. It is very clear. We have found double integral for five surfaces. That is front, back, right, left and top. Now, regarding the LHS, it is clearly given a closed curve f vector dot dr vector. Since the bottom is neglected or bottom is deleted, bottom is not there, or above xy plane, all are same, we have to visualize this. I am going to find the closed line integral over this lines. So let us say it as OA B, C. So, I am going to find f vector dot dr vector in the closed path OA, BC. I am going to do one by one along OA, along AB, along BC and along CO. Let us zoom the bottom surface alone. We have this figure. Next, we have to give the direction. We always do with anti-clockwise direction. Done. Next, we have to mention the equations. At x-axis, we have to write the lower limit of y, that is y equal to 0. At y-axis, the lower limit of x, x equal to 0. Then, parallel to y equal to 0, it is going to be my y equal to 2, that is my upper limit. Similarly, here we have x equal to 2. Next, we are going to mark the vertices. So, first we have to draw the figure, mark the direction, write the equation. Now, it is very easy for you to write the vertices. We'll take the four points. I'm just going to name it as O, A, B and C. So the points are obviously X, Y. See here, in this place, two lines are intersecting. X is 0, Y is 0. For A, we have X is 2, Y is 0. For B, 2, 2. For C, X is 0, Y is 2. You can easily copy the content from your own image. So, it is easy for us now to visualize the figure. For the closed integral over the curve C, F vector dot dr vector, I am going to split into four different lines. Along OA, this first line, and then along AB, along BC, and along CO. You can see, this is what my job in LHS. Let us do one by one, students. Now, this is very important. We have to take the final one. Along OA, see the figure. Now, I am considering only OA. Along OA, the equation is y equal to 0. And then, the direction is from O to A. So my equation is y equal to 0. So I can write dy 0. Limits, since y is fixed here, my limits are going to be x. So the starting value of x is 0 and it ends at 2. So limits are x equal to 0 to x equal to 2. So we have to write it very clear. Equation y equal to 0, dy 0 then. Then limits are x equal to 0 to 2. Now integral over the line OA, f vector dot dr vector. The limits are 0 to 2. Substitute this y equal to 0 and dy equal to 0 here. When I substitute dy equal to 0, this term is completely 0. When I put y equal to 0, it is simply 2dx. Integrating this, we'll be getting x. When I substitute the limits, my answer is 4. Very, very simple, students. You see this f vector dot dr vector. It has initially three variables, x, y, z. From the given question, we put z equal to 0 because it was neglected and dz 0. We turn the question in terms of x, y. Now, from the given problem, we are neglecting y and dy. Easily convert the data which fit for my line integral. Next, along AB, let us go to the figure and visualize it. Along the line AB, the direction is from A to B. So the equation is x equal to 2. So we can get dx equal to 0. Since x is fixed here, my limits are going to be varying from 0 to 2 because the direction is A to B. Therefore, my y limits are from 0 to 2. So let us write this equation x equal to 2, dx 0. Limits are y equal to 0 to 2. Now substituting dx 0, this term is going to be 0. There is no x term here. So we'll get simply 4dy. Along the line AB, integral 0 to 2 because the limit is 0 to 2, f vector dot dr vector is 4dy. Integrating this, we'll be getting the answer 8. Such a easy problem, student. You have to visualize the problem and you have to solve it in a very simple way. Now, next we are going for the line BC. We should be very careful here. Let us view the figure. When I go for BC, this is the line and my direction is going to be from B to C. So my equation is y equal to 2 and we'll get dy 0. Since y is fixed, so we have x limits. See here, the direction is from B to C. So my starting point of x is 2 and ending point of x is 0. The x limit is 2 to 0. You should not write 0 to 2. You should be very careful with this direction. Therefore, write the equation y equal to 2 dy 0. Limits are 2 to 0. Now substituting dy 0, this term is 0. And y equal to 2, if I substitute, I'll be getting 2 plus 2, 4 dx. My limits are 2 to 0. I'll take this 4 outside. Integration is x. Limits are 2 to 0. So 4 into 0 minus 2. My answer is going to be minus 8. This is for the line BC. And finally, we have the line CO. See the image. CO and the direction is from C to O. So the fixed equation is x equal to 0. We get dx 0. Then the limits are going to be obviously y limits since x is fixed. See the direction from C to O. So 2 to 0. Therefore, my y limit is y equal to 2 to y equal to 0. Let us write x equal to 0, dx equal to 0, and limits are y equal to 2 to 0, and integral over CO. Therefore, the limits are 2 to 0. When I substitute x equal to 0, and now the limits are 2 to 0. When I substitute dx equal to 0, this term is completely 0. There is no x term here. So I can write simply 4dy. Integrating this, we'll get 4 into y. The limits are 2 to 0. So 4 into 0 minus 2. Again, we get minus 8 as like BC. Therefore, we have evaluated all the 4 line integrals. Now, we have to add everything. 4 plus 8 minus 8. Minus 8. So the answer is going to be minus 4. So in our RHS also we get the same minus 4. Therefore my LHS and RHS are same. Hence Stokes theorem is verified for the given F vector. Hope you understand, student.
Thanks for watching. Hope you found this video helpful. Subscribe to our channel and share it to your friends. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.